can I get closer to God? You know, that's one of the most frequently asked questions in our 700 Club email box. It's also the subject of a new book by a well-loved author and speaker. Take a look.
Bishop Wellington Boone is a best-selling author, nationally recognized speaker, and the founding pastor of the Father's House Church in Georgia.
You see, the reason he sent us the Holy Ghost is so that we don't have to do this great battle by ourselves.
In his latest book, Your Journey with God, Bishop Boone coaches you on how to develop a new level of intimacy with God.
Please welcome back to the 700 Club our dear friend Wellington Boone. It's always a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you. It's great being
you
here.
Always Thank bring you. A fresh word and a good word from
you.
The Lord. We want to talk about your journey with God, the title of your new book. There is within us, Wellington, I think, a longing to know whether we know there's a God and who He is, or just a longing to know that there's something more than ourselves. And why is that in us? What is that about?
I believe we were made to satisfy the purpose that God made us for. Mm. And I think that after the fall, we fell away from understanding that we were called, for one, to be like God, and secondly, to do what God would do, to yeah. actually please Him in every way.
Yeah. Why is it so hard for us to know how to do that? I mean, people seem to struggle with that, don't you think?
Yeah, I think with the fall, it was a break in terms of intimacy with God. And the idea of prayer calls us back to a personal relationship with Him.
Yeah.
I've noted this. I was doing a lot of things, you know, as far as the call of God on my life. But what a person is in private
yeah.
is what he is in God.
Mm-hmm.
Think about all the great people, both in the past and all the ones of the Bible. It was God's encounter with them in private.
Yeah.
That allowed them to have the impact out in the public.
Yeah, that's so true. That those kinds of encounters never, even Paul, you know, they don't happen in, for the most part. I know someone can have a move of the Spirit on them in a great meeting or something like that, but those moments where God speaks something to your heart
yeah.
are usually one-on-one.
Yeah.
How do you get that intimacy?
Well, first of all, I believe that God predestinates all of us to be born again. That's why 2,000 years ago Jesus died.
Mm-hmm.
Somehow he allows us to get in a circumstance where we cry out to Him. He comes to us, makes Himself known to us, and it begins a pathway. Now, we're saved from hell.
Yeah.
Now the issue is transformation.
Yes.
The same call that God had with Adam, called Adam to be made in His image and likeness. Jesus comes as the last Adam
mm-hmm.
and said, whom He foreknew, them He also did predestinate to be conformed to the image of His Son. The whole idea, yeah. I know the will of God for every person, is to be like Jesus.
Yeah.
So under that microscope, we ask ourselves, do we think like He thinks? Do we talk like He talks? Mm-hmm. Do we do what He does? And then we look around and we say, I don't think so.
Yeah.
So then it's a matter of,
missing.
Yeah, go back to Him and cry out.
Yeah.
I believe we need the Holy Spirit to help us.
Yeah.
But it's not just to help us get through our sickness, even though God's a great healer. Help us in our financial situations, even though He'll help us. I believe it's to help us to become like Him.
Mm-hmm.
Because being like Him is our greatest need.
Yeah. Your book is all about that journey to intimacy. And talk a little bit about the role of prayer in that. Because when you talk about crying out to Him, that's a very personal heart cry. And the kind of prayer you're talking about isn't something you just have to do and you do by rote. It's that kind of cry out from your heart, not always in a scenario of need, but of wanting more of Him, of wanting to be more like Him.
Yeah, I love the scripture. It says, and we have this confidence
yeah.
that if we ask anything according to His will, we know He hears us.
Yeah.
Now, wait a minute then. So sometimes the according to His will is left out. You can ask Him anything. He's not going to do anything because we're not going to become His director.
Yes.
So it's going to God to say, God, first of all, what do you want out of my life?
Mm-hmm.
If God doesn't tell you that, then you have to live by principle.
Yeah.
So I created this book to help us in this pathway because I find a lot of people move with God from circumstance to circumstance. I call that tripping. But our life with God is a journey.
Yeah. And you've got a 30-day journey in here that we can, that's not meant to end at 30 days, but really to begin
yeah.
a lifetime, a way of life.
30 is really a prophetic number. Jesus, to be a rabbinic order, 30 years training before you become a rabbi, you know, yeah. Really. When you look at it, Jesus at age 30 became, he really was a rabbi.
Yes.
People don't realize that.
Yes.
But you do anything for 30 straight days, it becomes a habit. So I put in here historical habits that great people
yes,
have done
that.
In their lives that we could follow as patterns, principles that mm-hmm. help us with the issue of consecration.
God's given us so many opportunities to be wise about these things yes. if we will listen and learn and take action.
Yes.
And that's what your book does. It encourages us to do that in a journey toward
it's not
that.
Just a read-through, it's a work-through.
No, it is a work-through.
Yeah.
Exactly. It's much more than a book. I want to mention, it's called Your Journey with God. If you're somebody, you know, we often hear from many of you in email, how can I be closer to God? I feel like God's presence has left me. This is available wherever books are sold. And if you're looking for a way to get that intimacy back, then you're going to want to get a hold of this.